Right here, right now on JVTV, Henry Rollins is in the studio.
So remember last time you were here?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, was it enjoyable or?
It was challenging.
Oh, challenging.
He threw a few non sequiturs at me. I was like, I have no idea what to say. But no, I remember very well. In fact, when I saw your name on the itinerary, I was like, oh yeah, that place. And I remember this area.
Now, your latest CD, I got to tell you, you got to make some more videos in the same guerrilla style. Well, look at your video. You even said that the one you just did, you know, because it was different. It wasn't your normal video,
right?
You know, that people probably won't accept it that way. But I think it's great just seeing you do something that's totally different.
Well, it's wild. I mean, the only real set footage where that was controlled was the band stuff. We did that in L.A. at a rooftop, as you can see from the big pull-away shot at the end. The rest of it was like literally a camera on one guy's shoulder, another guy with a handheld, like one of those little hand cams. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the footage you see on this video, that's from the handheld camera. That's on the, you know, those little video cassettes.
DV cam.
Yeah, exactly.
You have loyal fans. I mean, every time we play any of your videos, like in our request shows and stuff, people always call in, oh, play like, well, of course, the one you hate.
I don't hate it. I'm just tired of it. But, it's only, you know, Liar is only boring to me is just because we wrote it so quickly. Wrote in 5 minutes.
Really?
It's just one of those things. Yeah, it was a joke. One day our bass player was playing, his first day of band practice. Bass player is playing like this porno soundtrack bass line. And I just start rapping over like, yeah, baby, you know, I'm just doing this thing. And I came to the punchline, you know why everything's so great? Because I'm a liar. And everyone in the band fell over laughing. I said, okay, there's a song idea. It was just basically a bada bing, bada boom joke we would do on stage. It was all improv.
Well, they had, you know, the legendary George Clinton. Mm-hmm. So how was it like working with George?
Well, I met George about a year ago. Basically, tomorrow I'm going to go do press at the Grammys tomorrow morning. And I met him at that press thing. And I'm not on the Grammys. I'm not going to the Grammys. You know, I couldn't be bothered. But in walks George Clinton. I'm like, well, now there's someone I want to meet. I want to meet the Temptations, but you couldn't get close to him. You know? And too bad. But there's George. I'm like, whoa, George Clinton, he's the man. And he sees me, and he comes right over to me and, like, hugs me. And he goes, Henry Rollins. I'm like, you know who I am? He goes, oh, man, big fan. It's like, whoa. So we ended up hanging out and doing radio interviews together, all these photos. He's like, the coolest guy. And he said, you got to be on my next record. I said, gee, okay. 2 days later, I get a call back from George's people. Like, okay, he's in town. He wants to do this. Do you know a studio he can work at? I'm like, yeah. Well, do you know any musicians? I said, oh, am I booking the studio and assembling a band? She went, well, yeah. Is that cool? I was like, sure. So the night before at band practice, I went in and told my boys, I'm doing a track with George Clinton. That was really fun to work with George, and he's such a cool guy, and he loved the band, and he and I got along, and, you know, it's like once in a lifetime.